Welcome back to my channel. Today what I'm doing is a SeaWorld tips and tricks, the best way for you to have a great time at SeaWorld. So we recently just got back from our vacation to Daytona Beach, where we took a day trip over to SeaWorld. It's almost a 2-hour drive with traffic from Daytona Beach to SeaWorld. Definitely recommend doing so, because a lot of times when we go to Orlando, we go for a week trip at Disney. We don't do a week trip at some of the other theme parks. So if you were wanting to do a day trip to one of those other theme parks, would be a great idea. We chose SeaWorld instead of Universal because after looking at it, it looked like it was gonna be about $1,000 for the three of us to do both parks and a park hopper. Not gonna do that. Instead, we came out for about $200 for three of us to go. Huge difference in price. And it turned out really, really, really good. So some tips and tricks. First, I'll talk about booking it. Definitely recommend booking it online, or at least going through like online process, and then you could also like call them if you want to make sure you get that rate. But online pricing, definitely recommend it. You can go ahead and purchase it online and then you have them like that. Quick Queue, we did purchase it because they did offer us this option for a $15 upgrade to Quick Queue Unlimited. Well, there is some things with the Quick Queue. So Quick Queue with Sesame Street area, which is their brand new area, only thing at all that had Quick Queue there was the Meeting Elmo and Cookie Monster meet and greet. Everything else was just lines. Did not know that, did all this research on it, and no one really said anything about it because no one does reviews on SeaWorld. You have so many people doing reviews on Disney. There's just all kinds of information out there. So here's kind of my information on it. Quick Queue, they don't have anything at Sesame Street but the Meet Elmo and the Meet Cookie Monster. The major rides do have Quick Queue. So like the Manta, the Meku, and the Kraken, the three roller coasters do have Quick Queue. Definitely recommend it for that. Kraken, it was not a good experience with the Quick Queue because that ride was built a long time ago and it wasn't built for Quick Queue, and the ride attendant was very confused about what was going on. So that one wasn't necessarily a great experience, but I think it had to do with the ride attendant. I will say Infinity Falls, I had planned the whole time that I was gonna use Quick Queue. I'd read, oh, it has it. Yes, it does have Quick Queue, but the regular Quick Queue Unlimited, you can only use after the first year that the ride has been open. And it's a brand new ride this year. And so I did not get to use Quick Queue, even though we'd already purchased it. You can use what's called Quick Queue Unlimited Plus, which is where it does include the new ride. We didn't look to see how much that was. It wasn't clear in the directions. The website at SeaWorld is a little bit off. So that one I don't know. And then also Quick Queue, you may assume, I mean, I did look into that, so I didn't know this ahead of time. You may assume that the shows will be included because a major part of SeaWorld is its shows, and that is definitely something not to be missed. If you were going to SeaWorld, you must go to the shows, not because you need it to fill time, but because they are phenomenal. And they are short. So if you're worried about your kids like thinking it's too long, don't worry. The Dolphin Show, which was probably the best show this time that we went to, it was only 22 minutes. So not too bad. I would like to have it at 30, 35 minutes for sure. But just worry, it's not an hour. You can make it even with a 1-year-old, which I did. So Quick Queue though does not include any kind of reserve seating for shows. So with shows, you would need to be there, they say 30 minutes in advance. At all of our shows we went to, and we went in the late July, and all of our shows we went to, there was seating up until 10 minutes, you know, 5-10 minutes before the show. And there's still seating. Now, it was not very good seating. It was in the very back of the theater, up really, really high. Definitely not in the soak zone, like where you could get wet while the dolphins and the killer whales splash you. So if you really wanted to get that splash zone area, like if you have about, I don't know, late elementary, middle school age kids who want to get wet, then you definitely want to get there 30 minutes in advance. I have a 5-year-old and a 1-year-old who do not, maybe want to get wet one time, but like wouldn't want to get wet like lots and lots of times. So we definitely wanted out of the soak zone. We were there 30 minutes before each show and we got probably the best seats in the house. Didn't need to have reserve ticketing, just get there 30 minutes before if you want. What we always did is we go get our seats and then like we would just kind of take turns on someone would go to the bathroom or we'd go get a snack or something like that. And they do usually have a little bit of a pre-show kind of thing, especially before the Sea Lion show. They do have the like mime who comes out there, which was really entertaining. And they do start pretty much like right on the dot. So they're really good about their times. So just be aware about the shows. If you're gonna try to be like, I'm gonna be there right at time, it's gonna be really harder to find a seat. But you know, if you try to plan 15 minutes before, you'll still find a seat normally. Some other things with your, you should plan for your day. Like I did plan, we didn't originally plan for us to go to SeaWorld, but then we decided to. Definitely recommend planning so that you can get the most out of your day. Okay, so planning, plan for that. I did try to do some planning, but had I known, QuickQue would not have been able to be used on Sesame Street and Infinity Falls, I would have done it completely different. So, for example, if you'll watch my next video is actually gonna be my new SeaWorld itinerary that I would choose to do if I was doing it right now, like, you know, in the summer when it's, or anytime when it's really, really busy. But so that's something, make sure you get a plan and know if you're gonna do QuickQue or if you're not gonna do QuickQue and what they go with, you know, like what does the QuickQue include? The refill drink, definitely a great option in the heat of the summer because you're very thirsty. If you get the refill drinks, they actually have free slushes as well as regular drinks the entire day. So we probably had like 8 or 9 slushes, which is a lot, but we had a bunch of people that we didn't mind sharing the same drink, which some people may be opposed to that. So we had 2 drinks, we got 2 of the drink things, and we shared it between the 4 of us easily, and even my dad had a little bit of it as well, and he wished he had done it. And so it's definitely worth the money for the refill. Now, if you're a season pass holder, it may not, I mean, it'd be worth it for the first day, but I don't know if it'd be worth it every single season. So that's kind of up to you on that one. But if you're coming in for one day and it's summertime, I would recommend doing that. But they do give ice water. So if you just want to do water all day, just bring a Yeti and go for it. You could also do that as well. Definitely recommend, do not pay for preferred parking. If you get there, we got there 15 minutes before park opening and we were 3 rows away from the front gate. So don't overpay. Just as if you can get there right on time for opening, then that would be perfect time to get a good parking spot. No problem there. Okay, so as far as tips, that was the end. QuickQue is a good option, but do realize what it includes and what it doesn't before you plan your day. Second, plan your day. Third tip is make sure you arrive at least 15 minutes, about 30 minutes before a show so you can get good seating. And just make sure you get there before the show starts and make sure you see them. So that's a third tip. Fourth tip is make sure you get a refillable drink. And fifth tip, don't pay for preferred parking. I believe that is all my tips. Also, extra bonus tip. If you do arrive early and you have already seen other things and you're not in a bigger hurry for rides and everything, and if it's a very slow day, if you go to the aquariums first thing in the mornings, those tend to be when they're feeding them and they're very, very active. So we were able to go about an hour after park opened and they were doing the feedings at the turtles and at the manatees. Now, a lot of times they will put those on the back of the map as well as with your show times. But that is also, the show times is also on the website, but the map will have updated ones of those and the feeding schedules as well. So thanks for watching. God bless, be of interest, and I'll see you next time. Bye.